say from Gatsby Hammer, so we get here, and we get this, and we take Cookie over. We'll do it as an exercise first, and I'll show you what I mean. So the next side from Gatsby Hammer, here, yeah? We're moving.
Yeah.
Here. That's it. Gatsby Hammer. Now, most times, we're seeing this as an exercise. Look where his elbow is. Can you see? Even as an exercise, it's dangerous. If his hand slips off, it hits me. So ideally, as an exercise, and this then goes into the technique, here, the hand's heavy, I've got the centre, I feed in. This back hand rolls his elbow. So not only do I get extension here, but I push through his centre with this. And it protects me. And it's here. Nice little lap, isn't it?
Yes.
Here. So I just drop my centre here to start off. Okay? So I'm good. Drop my centre. Hand moves in, I extend. See how the back hand comes in. Here. So this is important, this doesn't damage me. So we do it as a back exercise and then we'll do it as a technique. Okay, so I'll try and show you it as it. So all we're doing is just dropping the centre, heavy hand, feed me. You okay with that yet? Oh, yeah. Oh, hey, let's see. You look good, you've got a t-shirt on. Hey, how are you doing? Yeah? So really, it's not very good. Look, you know, yeah. It's like I'm running
too fast. Yes, yes, let's see. I know we've got this. I said, they know what to back.
Around it. Even though he's striking me there, I'm moving forward. So I'm moving his centre and coming back. The quicker I can move in, the easier he's walking his throw. So he hits. Hey, guys! Sometimes you have to finish me in Aikido. Sometimes you can't wait. So I'll put off pushing the elbow into your centre. So here. So I think the way I do it, I took the shoulders. Here, pinch up. So it doesn't matter whether you're big or small. Yeah, this is dropping centre. I come over with the hip. From what I sense here was actually it took me a minute time to do this. I was trailing and I was doing right at the time, I was quite strong up front. Reasonably. Feeling of this, I go in here, then I turn and I think, in my mind's eye, I don't have to do that. That's why I say, put something of unity. So, as he comes in, I'm just turning. Yes? You've got to make sure you feel comfortable and know the power of it. So, the worst thing is to turn, draw down. I simple myself here, so it's nice and relaxed. And I can turn and move. You okay with that? Nice, easy move. Same technique, good move. Okay? This tiki tangle is important. But as I raise up, this has got to be in the position so I can strike him if need be. My shoulder line must be strong as is. If I am used to doing this, he'll hit me. Yeah? So I go up. It's got to be strong enough to that. If I'm using bock end, go with the bock end, and I put him up with the bock end. So as I raise, here, and I feel the power. And that's for some of the small as well. I drop the hip. Straight away, balance is gone. I can drive into this ribcage with my knee. So moving forward, I need to on the shoulder. To the floor as quickly as possible. Here, the hand away from your groin. Here, you do a nice shoulder grip. I'm trapped in the corner, so I have to come this way. You can now tap me, you can see the pressure, and I make my escape. The leg.
You've lost the rest.
Ah. The reason that the this could be gossip. I mean, here, if I swing it, I'm blocking my own arm.
Right.
Just, see what I mean?
Yes.
So, the reason it's here. Wait a minute, I'm so. You see me so what? Walk your right.
Okay.
Now it's more manageable, yes?
Okay.
Put his hands down. Hand over the elbow. No, no, not the shoulder. It's too strong. This is lots of bulk of the strength.
Okay.
Here we use the joint to manipulate this bulk. Yes, so from there, push through the elbow and then the wrist up. And the wrist up, push through.
Okay.
Push. We find that the walkway, hopefully not.